So yeah, so this is one of the main ways in. Is through this courtyard here. Let's see if we can. Let me wait a moment and see if I can get them all to cluster. But as you can see, it's a little hard to do that. There's three of them that are kind of close, but I don't think I can hit all of them at the same time. Maybe when this one that's up on top of the stairs comes to the left side. Let's see if we can make this work. Nope, she's walking away. Rip. Oh, I almost fell off. There's one right underneath me there as well. Let's just... Yeah, I got two kills there.
What? Sister, are you?
What?
I missed. That sucks.
Who's that? Who's there? There was someone.
Where is...
Time to cry and bleed!
Yeah, too bad. Would have been pretty cool, but it's actually pretty efficient to come down this way because I need to get into the lower level anyway. Because I need to go get some of the loot that's down there. Oh, nice. We get to watch the witch get eaten apart again. That's gruesome. But, yeah, sorry. So the entrance to the bottom, we can get in there right through here. Do you like what I did there? I think that alerted the other witches that are near here. But I can duck down here if they come nearby. There's some whale bones around here. Yeah, here's a bunch. Which is pretty nice. Okay. I did want to go see this fella. Breaking and entering job. Use cliffside outside office window to get over fence. Drop down and enter basement through delivery door. Special displays on second floor. Go through, or enter through security room. Grab Roseboro prototype. Easy money. This is the important part. Don't forget to disable alarm. Alright, friend, we won't. Looks like you didn't do quite as well as we did. But let's see here. There are a couple of witches over there, but I don't see them. They're usually hanging out down here. I kind of just want to throw this anyway. Because at least it'll knock out these stupid nests. Which it did. I like this painting. Okay. Let's kill these things. I hear them. Where are they? Well, I guess they'll make themselves apparent to me soon enough. Get that blood amber. Like, as annoying as these things are, it's almost always worth it to take them out because you'll get the money for it. There's that. And here's a book. What does this book say? No, it's just a book by Anton. So yeah, we have the door, the block to this door. Reminder, the key to the archives is in the quartermaster office. That's not the only way through here, I don't think. You can get through there if you have possession. And I think there's some other ways, like if you can sneak around here. I think this somehow can get you in, just like that. If you just push. It's a little lame, but... There's another copy of the key. There's another rune right here. Which is great. And then... I also happen to know you can come here, and there's a really cool painting of, I'm not sure who, but we're gonna take it anyway. Because why wouldn't we? Okay, nothing else back here. Let's go ahead and listen to this audiograph.
After Delilah fell to the assassin Dowd, her magic was lost, and the coven scattered. I made a new life in KARNACA.
Whoops.
After Delilah fell to the assassin Dowd, her magic was lost, and the coven scattered. I made a new life in KARNACA. Then I heard her whispering from the void, leading me to the Duke, who heard those same whispers. Together we worked to bring Delilah back into the world, changing the Empire from the home of Aramis Stilton, 3 years ago. Across the Isles, all of us who'd been with her at Brigmore and before, we felt the magic return. Others joined, new faces, new blood. Now, Delilah is immortal, forever. She holds Dunwall, and we've turned to corrupting the Oracular Order. The Overseers take guidance from their prophetic sisters, and soon we'll influence their dreams and visions.
Alright, heavy stuff. So that tells us what they were doing with the Oraculum. I think that there's... Where's this bone charm over here? Oh, I know where this is. Yeah, let's go grab this bone charm real quick. Back in here. There's a door that's blocked. If we had strength, we could break it down. I think we can just come here, and I think we can just shoot and let ourselves in. And let's find that bone charm. There it is. Hot cocktail. What does that do again? Exploding bottles inflict damage over a wider area. Very cool. Here's the archive key as well, if he couldn't find it upstairs. And I'm just trying to find other goodies while we're down here. Looks like just a rewire tool. Oh, also you can get in there through this spot here. So anyway, I think there's just a couple things left to do here. Besides watch the witches get eaten. Let's come into here. It's kind of weird. Every time I come to this level, my sound kind of gets bugged around here. I don't know exactly why. Like, you can't hear this cast register or anything. I don't know what that's all about. But, whatever. Where else? That goes downstairs. There's nothing in here. Then up here. We've kind of already been up here, I think. Let's, do this. Take that out. Yeah, this is now kind of where we started. But anyway, what I do need to do is going through the main door to the conservatory here. Oh, if you guys wanted to... Oh, there's a witch. Oh, come on, I just want to drop kill her. And that didn't work. Where did she go? Alright, there we go. Took head clean off. Oh, there's still more witches around here. Where are they? Oh, there she is.
No. No way. No.
Oh, there's two of them. Oh, there's three of them. I think I got them. Yeah. All right, that got them. They disappeared, but when they reappeared, they all died. So that works for me. Anyway, this is the Oraculum, in case you guys were wondering. So what you can do.
How does this even work?
What you can do is you can install lenses here, and these are what allow Brianna to see into the void, but there's like lenses up in her office that are faulty, and if you install them and then apply, like, use the Oraculum on her, it'll actually lose her to cause her to lose her connection to the void, which is pretty awesome. I think this describes it here. All of you, if you share my loyalty to Delilah and to our coven, heed my words. Again, I was haunted by nightmares about the Oraculum. The original lenses Jindosh used in the device nearly ruined me. I felt Delilah's magic flicker, and the flame she rekindled in me almost went dark, like it did after Brigmore 15 years ago. I fear another accident like that will cost me everything. My connection to the void, to magic itself. We cannot afford any more mistakes. I will study the discarded lenses in my workshop, then have them destroyed. Remember that Delilah is relying on my efforts, and the Oraculum is attuned to me alone. Do not interfere with the device. Only I have a chance to control the Oracular Sisters. So that's what she was using that for. Where's this other witch? I just saw her. I'm glad that you can still, like, drop kill them and stuff. Because they're just, like, the witches are pretty hard to deal with, honestly. Okay. Yeah, so just so I can show you guys where it is, I think I'll go back to Ashworth's office. It's just right up here. I'm trying to think about where else there are paintings. Because I know I haven't gotten all of them. Anyway, they're right over here, the discarded lenses.
These odd lenses might be linked to what Ashworth is working on.
Yeah, the original lenses Jindosh and I devised for the Oraculum were horribly flawed. Rather than focusing the energies of the void, the faulty lenses scattered them. My head was filled with noise, and the spiritual channel linking me to Delilah's magic was nearly extinguished. I will not cease my efforts until our coven controls the Sisters of the Oracular Order, but I know now that I proceed at grave risks. The old lenses could have been my ruin. They are stored in my workshop for now, but must be destroyed. Of course, we literally killed her, so no worries about that. Some raw whalebone, which we can use soon for the Astounding Clockwork Soldiers, which we can use to make our own bone charms, but we'll do that later. Okay, so anyway, I think that's everything I need from here. We can go through this door. There's a picture of Jessamine.
If you knew about Delilah, you shouldn't have kept it from me.
Probably is correct. Anyway, so I think the last thing we need to do is find our way to the Roseboro prototype, which is on the floor below us, I think. So let's go down there. Yep, right in there, there's the Roseboro prototype. So if you're quick about it, you can break this glass, then jump through, or you can shoot it, jump through, blink through, whatever. But there are subtler methods. If you can find the key, I'm not actually sure where you find the key, but you can go in through there. I bet that there is somewhere nearby a place where you can possess a rat and go in right through there. So that's an option. Or if you don't like any of those, there is a vent right up top where you can go. So that's no problem. And then once you're in here, you need to be careful because this red light means it's trapped. And you can turn off the alarm by using the rewire tool here. Don't hit the big red button. Whatever you do, don't hit it. All you need to do is deactivate it like that, and you're good to go. And there is a guard right here who has the security key on him, but that obviously doesn't really matter anymore. Now that we're inside and we have the Roseboro prototype. And that's just about everything. I do want to sneak down to the first floor. I think there are some witches still down here. There's at least some hounds there. Yeah, these witches are brutal. They're like completely, like, dismembering all of these overseers and stuff. It's really brutal. Sorry, so the last thing I want to look for, there's a blueprint lying around here that I want to grab. Not in this bathroom, but in general. Is it in here? It is. So rewire tool, there's the blueprint. It's cool, you can actually put this in here, and you can make a wall of light in this room, but I don't really know why you'd do that. So I've gotten two blueprints in this level, I'm pretty sure. I'm trying to think of some more. That's about all I can think of for now. Already came through here, yeah. Okay. So now let's head back to the black market shop. But before we do that, there will be some enemies here that we need to vanquish. I tried to get a sneaky kill on him, but it did not quite work. But yeah, now there should be some guards near here. Maybe what I'll do, this will be cool. Let me come down here. Do that. And then let's rewire it. Which I can do inside of here. And let's see if I can draw their attention. Because... yeah, there they are. There's at least one. Come on. Where'd you go? Here we go. There's one. There's the other one. Come here, man. You're not gonna hit me like that. No use running. And there's another. Come on, man.
You aren't going anywhere. Come back here.
Where'd he go? Come on. Are there any more? You can see it's running out of whale oil. Too many souls.
What are you waiting for? Kneel down to your... You won't get away.
Come on, man. I don't have all day. And there we go. That still is enough for one more. Instead, maybe we'll just bum rush through here. Oh, there's witches. Forgot about that. Does this blow up? No, it doesn't blow up, thankfully. The problem is the witches don't really run, they just kind of appear. Let's see if we can get her to run through this. It's not going poorly, I'm just not doing anything cool.
So you're marked? I need to cut off your head.
There we go. Oh, no, she blinked out of the way. There we go. What if we toss her head on through? And that was enough to get rid of the last bit of juice. So there you go. Okay. So now let's go back like we were describing. To the black market shop. And again, I'm just trying to think. I know I forgot some blueprints or something. But let's go in here.
What?
Let's deliver our
cover your face.
Deliver
what
our
do
goods.
Want? Welcome back. I see you found the prototype.
Your acquaintance didn't make it.
It is a risky line of work, I'm afraid, but let's not dwell. I expect you'll be interested in payment. First, your finder's fee, of course, and if you like, I can draw up some schematics based on the prototype, something you can use to modify your tools. And as a token of my appreciation, a discount at the shop.
A fair deal.
All right. Configurable grooving. Excellent.
Welcome back.
Please, yeah, here we go. Now we got some upgrades. Now we're talking.
I have some upgrade plans for your gear.
Let's give me these impact grenades.
Forward to the day when
I want those.
No need to run.
They will explode on impact now, which is quite nice. And yeah, we get some cool upgrades for our bow. Fire bolts at a high rate, semi-automatic firing, or aim lock up to 3 targets at once, firing a single splintered bolt. Only works with regular crossbow bolts. I'm not ready to choose, to be honest. I'm not sure which one I want. So I'm gonna choose to skip that for now, and I'm gonna do what I set up at the very beginning of the level. Let me go down here. We can run along. And this chain fell because of the thing that I hit at the beginning of the level. There's a bunch of goodies here, which is pretty nice. Stun mine.
I'd love to know who made that mask. Very interesting.
Are you sure? Usually they run away by now.
Oh, I knew this wouldn't work. You should have listened to Mother.
Sorry, man. Thanks for the sweet digs, though. Okay. Grenades. Lots of bathing salts. That's nice. Those will come in handy in the next level. And let's get all this stuff. Nope, open. Open. Another grenade, stun mine, spring razor, rune, and safe combination. But yes, with that, we finally have 6 runes, which means we can finally get stop time. And now the fun really begins. Okay, anything else in here that we want to grab? Yeah, here's some good stuff. Quite a lot of money in there. We had like 1600 a moment ago. Now we have 1600 again. because I guess I spent it on that impact grenade, which is pretty good. Oh, I'm glad that I didn't actually hit that with my sword. I just broke the glass. But anyway, now that we have the safe code, we can go get the last bone charm. And there was a portrait in there. I don't know if I grabbed it or not.
Hello?
Oh. Alright, so now we can finally do the cool stuff.
Damn.
Let's make this happen. Let's see. Yeah, just for style points, let's do that. Okay.
Someone is asking for trouble over there.
All right. It's so unnecessary that I kill, like, do the bloodthirst like that, but it's pretty cool, and that's what's really important. But yeah, but you can do stuff, like, you can put the spring razors on the arrows, on the bolts, and do, you know, and sort of turn it, the spring razor into a projectile, which is really cool. Yeah, you can do all sorts of cool stuff. Oh, that's cool. That was my bone charm. I had never used that one before. But anyway, let's see if we can get up to here. Get up to here. And then, as I mentioned before, okay, yeah. So here is the portrait that I almost walked by the first time, which I'm sure made some people angry for whoever's watching. And then 438 is the code. One, two, three. Okay. And then, yeah, our last bone charm should be in here. Okay, apparently it's not. Then what did I... Where's the bone charm that I thought was here? I guess there's nothing. I guess we got everything. But there's still some good loot in there that was worth picking up. I really think I'm one blueprint short. I really do. I'm not sure about paintings, though. Well, I can't think of it off the top of my head. So, what I'll do... Oh, that's cool. I like that a lot. I'll just go back to the skiff. There's a little cutscene that plays when we get there. I'll save, and then I'll check the progress of the mission. Really, you guys?
Impossible. I can't.
What's happening now? Huh? What? Let's try and knock this guy out. Or is he really not gonna make it easy?
Won't let you get away so easy.
Let's see. Oh, but I guess I killed him. Whoops. Just from my impact. That's pretty dang funny. Okay. Yeah, let's go do this cutscene.
So it's done.
Ashworth won't be a problem anymore.
Good. But Corvo, there's something else. Back when I lived in Dunwall, I did things that I'm not proud of.
You live long enough, that happens.
Yeah. But what I did is worse than most. I knew Delilah and Ashworth. Bought into their bullshit, which led me down a bad road. To be honest, before all this, I thought Delilah dead. I don't want to get into it right now, but I felt like you should know. There are things I regret, Corvo.
Deception doesn't make for good allies, Foster.
Is that what you think, Royal Protector? You'll have to tell me all your secrets someday. Are you ready to leave now?
Yeah, Corvo. You have to not be so judgmental.
Not yet.
All right. Just tell me when you're ready.
Alright, quick save, and talk to Megan Foster again. Yeah.
Yes, let's go. Take me
back. But I'm expecting to turn around.
Whale.
Another step toward the Duke of Sirkonos and Delilah. Let's go.
No, I got everything. How about that? And I got a lot of coins, too. Okay. I'm quite pleased, to be honest. Okay. Shrewd negotiations, parlay with Delilah. Got lots of cool stuff. So yeah, awesome. Let's move on. This is going to play a little cutscene, and then I will probably go ahead and save and end the episode after that. So let's hop on into it.
3 years ago, Delilah was laying her plans. The Duke's people gathered at the home of a mine baron named Aramis Stilton to commit some horror in her name. I need to know how they made her immortal. But where was I 3 years ago, letting Emily daydream through council meetings, teaching her fencing and back-alley fighting? I always expected an enemy we could put down with a sword. Soldiers, spies, assassins. Instead, we got something else, beyond the pale. Beyond the natural world. Instead, we got hit by someone like me.
And there you go. Very spooky. So yeah, another mission out of the way. It's pretty fun. And yeah, I'll end it here. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure you check back to the channel for more gaming and Pokemon content. And until the next time, I'll see you guys later.